great night of fights we've had here on Muay Thai Grand Prix and Kickboxing Grand Prix. Rob, tonight, I mean, look, we've seen some fantastic Muay Thai fights. We're going to get to that in a minute. But Bruno versus Vinicius fight was incredible.
Well,
the kickboxing one.
For two guys to fight like that, 5-3s, that pace they kept was just unbelievable.
Yeah, it was a breathtaking performance, and it just seemed like the engines of both of the fighters was just incredible. But the Portuguese fighter, Vinicius, just seemed to have that little bit of extra gumption in his shots.
Yeah.
But what a fight.
And skill as well, and some of the techniques he was pulling off, the high kicks in close, jumping, spinning kicks, it was just an incredible fight.
We also had some very interesting Muay Thai fights with the change of the guard, really, of the old school of Jono Chipchase trying to chase down the more elusive and more slippery Liam Patel.
He did well the first round, didn't he, Jono? He got given credit. He took the fight to Liam and was aggressive, but he just seemed to just run out of a little bit of energy as the fight went on. And, you know, against a fighter like Liam Patel, who's got a great range, great distance, and he controls that distance very well, it was always going to be hard for Jono.
Also, Anton Austin and Joe Turner fight.
Yeah.
Joe Turner seemed to be getting paggered the first round.
Yeah.
His leg was getting kicked off. He came back into the second round.
It was like he thought he was in a 5-round fight, wasn't it?
Indeed, and, yeah, indeed.
It started slow, and by the time he did start, it was too late. His leg was damaged, and it was just a bit too much of a mountain for him to climb.
Yeah, we've got to give Anton credit for that.
Yeah,
a great
definitely.
Performance from the two technical team, and it was just outrageous. Tonight, we also seen, in my opinion, a very big upset. Now, you've got to forgive me, because I've not seen Darren Anstey fight before. I was told he was good, but tonight he ripped the script up, didn't
that
he?
That was performance of the night for me.
Indeed.
You know, but performance of the night, you've got to give it to Darren Anstey. He came in there, he upset, you know, not, I don't think many people gave him a chance before the fight, especially after the highlight reel knockout we had from Saeed in his previous performance here, where it just went viral around the world. But, you know, he just came in and he just never gave him a moment to breathe in the fight, did he? Just kept him at distance, big powerful kicks, and Saeed didn't know what to do with him.
Yeah, it was
definitely.
An absolute superb performance. And finally, really, the Louis King was so on form, power shots, trying to punch Cervantes' head to the moon.
Yeah.
But he came through it, didn't he? With some devastating low kicks.
And he knew the Achilles heel, didn't he? I mean, obviously, he probably studied the Charles Sequa fight from before. It saw a weakness there, exploited it, which you got to do as a professional fighter at that level. You need to know how to turn a fight around in your favour and win, and he did.
And lastly but not leastly, Josh Hill. A spinning elbow from nowhere. An opponent that I don't think really deserved to be in the ring with him, or his record said different. However, Josh Hill made it look easy.
Yeah,
and that spinning elbow was classic.
It was probably one of the easiest fights he's ever had, to be fair. But, you know, you do what you do against who's put in front of you, and he did it in style.
It's been an absolute wonderful show. We'll be back very, very soon with more action with Rob and me, and we'll see you very soon. You're just like my favorite song, going round and round.